Hi, Roman Chaudry here. Before going into the tutorial, let me make it very clear that I am not a good English speaker at all. Although I am a little bit better in writing and stuff like that, but not good in speaking at all. So my apologies in the very beginning that I will be making some very pathetic mistakes during the process, during the tutorial. So yeah, you can laugh a bit, that is good for health. At least I will be the reason of your laugh, of your smile. So let's get into the tutorial. Although I have been making some previously some tutorials, like 7 to 8 tutorials I have made in Urdu language, because my basic intention was to make this thing to learn easily for the people of Pakistan. So far I have been receiving very good response in that, but recently I have got some requests from the people randomly on internet that I must make tutorials in English as well, like people from Arabian region, Egypt, Saudi Arabia, and from European countries who have been following me on Facebook or other social platforms. So finally I have decided to give it a try. Let's do it. I will see if this thing will be giving me a good response, then I will be expanding it in the future with the video recording as well. So for now I am going to start with the basic introduction of 3ds Max. I am hoping that you guys must have at least previewed 3ds Max before. I am not going to start with the zero, I am just going straightforwardly to the commands and to the importing method. Because my intention is to teach you rendering that we used to do in V-Ray and Corona, and there are also many other rendering engines, but mainstreamed are these two. Sorry. So let's get into the tutorial. Yeah, one thing more, if you face any issue during implementation of my tutorial, you can contact me freely without any hesitation through my email ID. You can email me at any time and I will be replying when I will be free, so don't worry about that, I will reply inshallah. So basically there are 4 viewports in 3ds Max. One is top view, the other is front, left and perspective. So these four viewports basically are working respectively. Like, let me make a little object in one of the viewport and we will see what will be happening in other viewports. Like, I am going in this toolbar that is geometry. Basically it's a create panel and it has sub buttons. Geometry is the first one. By geometry I will be making some geometrical objects like this. This is a T-port. So you can see clearly that what is happening in other three viewports. Like in perspective, I have a perspective view. We can call it a little bit of axonometric, but it's not clearly an axonometric, but you can call it. Axonometric is something else. It's a perspective. You need to Google what is the difference, basic difference between axonometric and perspective. In the top viewport, we can see its top version, top side from top. In front and in left, this is very clear. Let's move on to the other step. If we want to expand any viewport at any time, like I used to do, my whole workflow follows just one viewport, that is mainly perspective, and whenever I used to switch, I have to switch to any other view like top or front. I used to do in keeping myself within one viewport. I don't get myself minimized to back into these four viewports. Let me show you what I am talking about. Like, I am highlighting this, activating this perspective viewport, and how I will be expanding it. Like, you need to write down a short key, that is Alt plus W. When I press this, you can see it expanded. From 4 it became 1. And by pressing Alt W again, Alt W, Alt Alt plus W, it restores. So it's a very simple, quick view, short key. And if I want to go to another view, like top or front or bottom or whatever. I don't need to switch back to four viewports and go to the top one and then to expand it. No, it's a lengthy process. Make your life easier by simply pressing, if you want to go to the top view, simply press T. It will automatically go into the top view. One thing, and other thing is, if you want to go into the front view, F for front. Basically, first alphabets are interpreting these short keys of these commands. And if you want to go into perspective, you need to simply type P for perspective. I hope these things are pretty clear, not a big science in this. Okay, if you want to rotate the perspective view, don't ever try to rotate the top view. If your object is in top or front or bottom view type things, don't ever try to rotate that. You will mess it up ultimately. If you want to rotate your view, simply go into the perspective and by pressing Alt and scroll key all together and dragging your mouse, you will be ultimately rotating the view. So my one hand is busy in basically handling the mic, so I am basically using a single hand for all that for using this Max. So I'm not going to use this short key, but the here is the button, orbit subject sub object named button, the second last button in 3ds Max, left bottom corner, right bottom corner. If look, I have pressed it and it gave me a sign that is showing the orbit, that is a circle. If I will keep my cursor, before going into that, let me tell you another short key, that is for grid. You can see this grid beneath the teapot. If I press G, it is switching on and switching it on off. So I am going to switch it off because it was creating a mess for me. So now let's get back to the orbit thing. This is the cursor that is showing orbit rotation type thing. Now what if, see, I have clicked and started dragging the mouse, it has started rotating the view. But as soon as I will go out of this orbit, and now when I will be clicking the mouse key, what you are seeing is it is rotating along an axis. Either it can be X, Y, it can be Y, Z. It depends upon which direction you move it. So basically, I will highly recommend you to use Alt key plus scroll key altogether to freely rotate your model, because this short key creates a little mess that can be difficult for you to understand initially. So go with the short key, highly recommended. So if you want to move an object in 3ds Max, what you have to do is select that object. Here you can find a move select and move button, simply press it. Then you can see this axis constraint sign, and these will guide you where, in which direction you want to move your model. Like in X axis, you can move it negative X, positive X, Z. This sign, blue line, is showing depicting the Z dimension, Z side. So this moves it along to the Z, and same is the case with Y. Its short key is W. For the movement, you need to press W from your keyboard and it's activated. You will find it activated. Okay, the next short key or the command that we use frequently is rotation. Move, rotation and scale, these are basically the three most frequently used commands in 3ds Max other than rendering. So rotation as soon as I activated the rotation key, its short key is E. Basically E, W, E, R, these are the three short keys of these three commands. So this is up to you. I'm leaving this up to you to explore these commands in detail, because today I am just giving an overview what is 3ds Max and how it works. I don't want it to make difficult for in the very initial stage to understand it. Okay, moving on to other step, let me tell you about some online platforms yet that you must explore before starting 3ds Max properly. Go into the google.com, the worldwide famous search engine, I'm hoping that you know, that you all know about it. It's not a big deal. Okay, first of all you need to see an animation that I used to show everyone before starting their tutorials, the third and the seventh. It's a brilliantly done animation by the great Alex Roman. The guy's name is Alex Roman. My name is Roman, his name is Roman. I'm not Roman, he is not Roman, so don't confuse me with his name. So the first link will be the Vimeo's link that will take you to its animation. You need to see this. The whole animation is made in 3ds Max and the year was 2010 when he made this. But till date, it's the most, what I can say, it's the most brilliant animation ever made in this planet. This guy is the biggest inspiration for whole CG industry. He made this animation solely alone within 2 years by committing 2 complete years on this animation. He gave his best for this industry. So I'm not going to play it. You need to play it at your own. My internet is slow here in Pakistan in Shahdara. So you need to play it. So see this. Other than this, you need to go on some basic websites. I will be adding these websites or these guys in description mode in the video. Under the video you can find them. I'm going to type there. So I'm not going to type in directly in Google. So I hope you will be installing 3ds Max soon in your machines. Right now don't focus on rendering, focus on the software, understand it, play with it, its commands. Do see what these geometries are bringing for you, like box, how the clicks work, how these commands are working. There is a short key named F3. If I look, I have pressed F3 and what it did, basically it's going from shaded to hollow and hollow to shaded, and only thing I can see is the wireframes of the geometry. My parrots are very lovely. They are shouting outside my room. I think you can listen their voice. Okay, so these two short keys F3 and F4, explore these as well. Explore what these other commands are doing, but don't delete these two, this toolbar at all, because I can't accommodate these kind of issues. So don't create a mess with the software. At least understand what is happening in the software. Install it, start it, let me know if you face an issue, so I will be resolving it for you. So I hope my English was not that bad at all. If there is any issue regarding my communication, my speed, if my speed accent is slow or fast, do tell me, because I'm very new to English. I'm a Punjabi speaking man. So thanks a lot, see you again.